Good evening, everyone. Phil here, and welcome to the Daily Wrap for what was Tuesday, the 16th of January, 2024. A lot went down today, so I certainly hope that you guys will listen up and enjoy. So, on today's Level 1 podcast, quite a lot of stuff. First of all, lots of news, tons of news stories. One news story about the potential that it's either YouTube and ad blocking software or a combination of both that is making people's PCs overheat. This is literally the reason why my music was skipping for the last week until I realized if I turned off ad block, everything worked fine. Kind of interesting. In addition, Ubisoft telling everyone they're just going to have to get used to never owning a game ever again. Yes, I'm not kidding. That's what an executive said. And many more things, many stories covered. In addition, on today's podcast, live, I posted up the ability for you to post up questions for tomorrow night's family night with Kat and Jasper. Just in case you cannot attend that stream in person, there is now a thread on the community tab of DSPGaming where you can post up questions for that show, and we're going to access that and reference it during the show if we run out of stuff to talk about on the stream with the live audience. So, good stuff. Good show today. I hope you'll check it out. And then today's first stream was Resident Evil 0 Remastered. Now, we're nearing the end of the game. In fact, we're very near the end of the game from what I'm to understand. But let me tell you, this final segment of the game is something else. It is probably the most backtracking, looping, time-wasting, annoying, shortcut opening, backtracking, looping, time-wasting, annoying. I could keep going. I think you understand what I'm saying. Basically, the finale of the game, it really feels like they completely ran out of ideas, and you're just going through this one or two smaller areas that all loop and have locked doors, but then you finally open it from one side, switch characters, do this, switch characters, do that. Multiple boss fights today. Some really annoying stuff. I ended up having to leave some items behind, and even though it's possible to technically go back and get them, it's really not even worth it. Good news is, after a very frustrating day, but progress, we're near the end of the game. We're actually, I believe we're at either the next to last or last boss fight, but there's more content after this boss. I'm not sure because I don't remember from the original playthrough. But yeah, we did great progress, and it looks like one more stream to wrap it up. So this weekend, absolutely, Resident Evil 0 Remastered will complete, which I'm happy about because obviously I want to finish up all lingering playthroughs and the like before we head into new releases a week from Friday. So it was good progress. Thanks to anyone who was there. Still remains my highest attended stream of all the streams I'm currently doing right now. excuse me. Also, tonight on the late stream, it was more Sea of Stars. This week, it was 3 Sea of Stars streams. Really happy I did that because it was a lot of content and a lot of fun. Tonight was super epic. We finished up the Necromancer's Lair dungeon. Then we went on to a whole other dungeon, this Haunted Mansion, and did the whole thing, epic fight at the end, crazy plot twists and interesting plot development, and super fun. My one regret is that for some reason, this playthrough, Sea of Stars, which is an outstanding RPG that plays like ones from my youth, but only a modern-day new one, that it's just not getting attention. You know, we could barely get 200 people on the stream most nights. The views on the videos on demand are not good. And it has nothing to do with me. It's the game. People, for some reason, don't tune in for indie games. And again, it's funny to me that over the years, so many people yelled at me, you don't play enough indies. So then finally I announced I'm going to play this indie game that was Game of the Year indie game that you guys wanted. And, you know, I can't get people to show up. So maybe that's why I don't play indie games, right? Anyway, good news is I'm loving it. And the one disappointing thing, though, that I found out tonight, someone told me the game's 40 hours long, and I'm like, I didn't know that. If I had known that Sea of Stars was 40 hours long, I'll be honest with you guys, I wouldn't have started it now, because I knew I didn't have 40 hours to play this game before the new releases hit this month. I feel like this is kind of almost like a waste of time, because what's going to end up happening is either Baldur's Gate or Sea of Stars or both are going to have to go on hiatus for me to play the new games, and then people are going to be upset, but what can I do, right? Like, honestly, of all the games, I like Sea of Stars a lot, but it's definitely the one that is going to probably go on hold for sure because it's getting the least attendance and attention on the channel, you see? So, it is what it is. I don't even know what to say. We're going to have maybe 2 more streams of it next week, and then it basically kind of goes on hold, and it comes back whenever we decide it's a good time for it to come back. I mean, it might potentially be late spring or summer, right? I definitely want to finish it. These first 12 hours I've played are outstanding. The game is super fun. I get why it was Indie Game of the Year. I just don't understand why I started it at this point if it's such a long game, right? Anyway, great streams today. One other thing, over on DSP Throwback today, a new part of Final Fantasy 13 went live. Tomorrow morning, a new part of Red Dead Redemption 1 will go live. And FYI, the poll is live, because I posted this up yesterday, for you guys to vote on what kind of first stream ever you want to see me do over on DSP Throwback. And let me tell you guys, the voting is this close. Just so you know, three stream possibilities. Stream possibility number one, a chill retro night, talking about old school YouTube and what it was like being a creator back then, and kind of a hangout session where maybe we'll even do some retro games over like the Switch Online, you know, program. Option number two, a live react stream to the Final Fantasy 13 playthrough on that channel. And option number three, a live react to the Red Dead Redemption playthrough on that channel. Right now, 43% for the chill retro night, 45% for the live react to Red Dead. It's a 2% difference, and 2% of 322 votes is 6 votes. So 6 people currently are determining what this stream is going to be over the weekend. It's probably going to be Sunday night, okay? So if you're interested on the first ever retro stream over on DSP Throwback, I urge you, head over there and vote on this poll, because your vote has giant impact right now on what I'm going to be doing for the very first stream over there. Okay? All right. So tomorrow, Wednesday, is my final consecutive streaming day of the week, and it's going to be a good one. First off, it is going to be the continuation of Baldur's Gate 3. We just finished the big boss fight in the Forge, so we're going to get our spoils from that fight, see what's remaining to do down there. I think there's an amulet I need to get for a quest, and then we're going to wrap that stuff up, and we're going to leave, and I believe the next place to go is the conclusion of Act 1, which is going to take place in the Mountain Pass. So I think we're going to the Mountain Pass to do those final quest lines or whatever they are, and then that's that, and then we're moving on. So let's see how far we get tomorrow, knowing this game and how it moves at a snail's pace. I doubt we're beating the Mountain Pass tomorrow. We're lucky if we even arrive there and do more than one thing. I guess we'll find out. But should be a good stream as always. Looking forward to getting the reward for that epic, what was it called? Grimm, his name? So that fight, or Gurm or Grimm, whatever his name was. Looking forward to getting my rewards and moving on from that. And continuing on with the game. Tomorrow night, yes, as I've already said, tomorrow, late night stream, 6:45 p.m. Pacific time. It is family night. Myself, Kat, and Jasper will be here together to do some Q&A with all of you, to talk and hang out and answer your live questions, do shout-outs. And now we have this thread, so if you can't be there tomorrow night, please post up in the thread. That's just going to be even more content for us to access and answer. All right, so it should be a fun, chill night tomorrow night to end the streaming week. I'm not here Thursday, but of course this next week coming up is the final kind of filler week before new releases come a week from Friday with Like a Dragon, Infinite Wealth, and Tekken 8. All right, guys, gals, thank you so much. Great streaming day today. I hope you all have a good evening. Enjoy the stuff on any channel. You know, there's content on every channel I'm doing right now, and tomorrow we wrap it all up and have a good one. All right, thank you guys, have a good night, peace out, see you in the morning, bye bye.